Today we're going to show you how to troubleshoot your clock using a multimeter, checking your voltage and checking the resistance on your loops. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing you want to do when you're diagnosing or troubleshooting an electrical system, irrigation electrical system, is make sure that the power is going into the appliance, in this case the clock. My dad was an electrician his whole life, and the first thing he always looked at is the thing that's not working getting the power. If you're not getting the power, it's not going to work. So the way we do that is with a multimeter. There's lots of different styles of multimeter. This is our Pro 30. It's a manual multimeter, so I have to select AC voltage and I have to select a range that's appropriate. In this case, these outlets usually put out 110, 120. So I'm going to put it on the 200 range. I'm going to insert the probes into the outlets. And before you do that, a little commercial here, just make sure you read the instructions on these things. It's a world of liability, and they've talked to you about how to be safe, how to be careful. Read those instructions from the manufacturer that you get. I'm going to insert these probes into the outlet. The number here says 122.2. Okay. So I know I've got power at this outlet. So if this were hooked to my clock, I would know that my clock is getting my source power. There's also multimeters like this one. It's called our Pro 90. And it is completely automatic. I don't have to dial anything on it. Same thing, insert those leads. 122.5. What's nice about this one, this Pro 90, is I don't have to do any dialing, any knowledge. It's monkey proof. You basically just insert it, it gives you the answer. Now I want to check the clock output to make sure that that's good. So on zone one, we've activated the zone one using the clock, using the manual controls, and if the clock is working properly, we should see 24 volts at that station. So I'm going to put my leads first on the common wire and second on station one, and I should get 24 volts or somewhere similar to it. Here I'm getting 26 plus. So that output is correct at that zone. Next thing I want to test is the resistance loop to the zone. So I'm going to take my multimeter, I'm going to connect it to the zone, and a good rule of thumb on these zones is they should come out between 20 and 60 ohms. There are some exceptions. Some recently released solenoids are about 75 ohms, but generally 20 to 60 is going to be what you're looking for. So I'm going to connect it here to my common and to the zone that I want to check. This one is showing 32 ohm resistance. That's good. That means that zone's good. If I were to get something less than 20 ohms, that probably means that I have a short or a bad splice out there. If I have what's called an overrange, which you see here, the OL, that means the wires are generally open or the solenoid's open. So it's either between 20 and 60 ohms is good, below 20 is bad, above 60 is bad. To sum it up, to do a complete test on your system electrically, you need a multimeter, whether it's this one or somebody else's. They're great for diagnostic tools. They obviously give you some good information as to where the fault lies. It's either going to be in the solenoid, in the wires, or in your clock, and this can test all three.